It is my great honor to welcome you to the senior piano recital of my son, Matthew Newton. A couple things we ask. Please silence your cell phones, and you are welcome to take pictures. Just please make sure the flash is off. And now, if you'd please join me in an opening prayer. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this beautiful day you've given to us for this recital. I thank you for this gift of music. I thank you for the great privilege it is to be able to listen to this performance in person and not virtual. And Lord, we ask now that this music may bless the hearts of all who hear it. I thank you very much for the gift of this son you've given me and for the gift of your son. We ask your blessings on tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
I am supposed to inform you that I've hired three expertly trained assassins to sit throughout the room and watch for dropped water bottles and people who clap between movements. The first three pieces I'll be performing are a set of preludes by George Gershwin. To put the timeline of Gershwin into a bit of perspective, Gershwin released his first hit composition in 1919, the first year, the year JBU was founded. And 7 years after that is when he wrote and published the pieces that I'm about to play. Gershwin was famous for bringing together the worlds of jazz and classical music. The first and third pieces that are faster and more rhythmic, whereas the second one is a sort of blues lullaby. In that way, they heavily portray the influence of jazz, while the performance setting and how the notes are all written out are heavily in the classical tradition. To finish about Gershwin, I'll leave you with this valuable life lesson. When he traveled to France to study under the famous classical musician Ravel, at that point Gershwin was already composing and performing in America. But out of concern that Ravel's classical training would snuff out Gershwin's jazz influence, Ravel turned him down, saying, "Why become a second-rate Ravel when you're already a first-rate Gershwin?" Please enjoy Gershwin's three preludes.
Thank you.
coming in at the earliest music in my program. The next set is from Couperin's Pièce de Clavecin. These pieces were composed in the early 18th century, making them almost as old as my jokes. The pieces are of French Baroque style, so they should feel refined, even restrained, and mildly pretentious in their simplicity and elegance. You could think of it as court music and imagine a bunch of rich people in these really tall, stiff collars dancing in a ballroom. The first piece, La Vandoline, pardon my French, literally translates to for the hair. That is most likely not what this piece, what this title is referring to. One source said it could refer to a woman from Bandol, though it is probably representing a stringed instrument of foreign origin. This is reinforced by the ornaments in the melody that is reminiscent of a plucked stringed instrument. The second piece directly translates to the little nothing and could be thought of as trifles. The last piece is named after women who are knitting. As you listen to the piece, you can hear how the fast, nimble movement is translated to the music.
Thank you.
thought it was important that I not wear a mask while I play, partly because masks are uncomfortable, but mainly so that you can see that, unlike the last pianist, I only have one nose. I hope you're able to hear Alex MacDonald in concert. Because Mozart is so widely known, I will only share some about what MacDonald taught in masterclass a couple weeks ago. Don't worry, I'm not going to say anything political. Mozart is most widely known for his operas. It can be helpful, then, to think of his piano sonatas as dramas in themselves. As I play, you'll hear these different voices and textures interacting with each other. Try to think of them as different characters in a drama, and see a story unfold as the piece progresses.
Thank you.
I hear some of you have come in without buying tickets. If you are one of those people, it's okay. You can pay me in cash after the performance. Okay, so fair warning, this next piece, some people might experience flashbacks to a certain Tom and Jerry episode. This is a very famous piece by Franz Liszt, so I'm not going to say a whole lot about it. Just know that it's very hard and a lot of fun. I hope that while I handle the hard part tonight, you all get to experience the fun. So sit back, enjoy, and yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sorry, it's getting a little warm under that suit jacket. All right, before we leave tonight, a few people I would like to thank who have been very meaningful. And first of all, Dr. Whitley. He has been incredible putting all his time and effort to help to learn these pieces both inside of our normal scheduled practice times and being willing to meet outside. And for Jackie Wren, my first piano teacher, who's watching online, just many years of patience and encouragement. It's very appreciated. I also want to thank all my music faculty and friends for making me a part of this crazy awesome group. my engineering classmates, who are always putting up with me leaving to go to rehearsal, practice, or whatever I've gotten myself into. And then a big shout out to my family, who have supported me, encouraged me through everything. My amazing girlfriend, Shauna, who is an inspiration and a caring friend. And most of all to God, who has been so faithful and just downright awesome. I think I've got one more piece tonight. Don't forget to enjoy the reception my family has graciously set up. Thank you for coming, and please enjoy.